Bats. There has been a lot of talk of late about bats possibly being the cause of COVID. Bats do pose some danger as transmitters of disease such as rabies, Ebola, and coronavirus such as SARS and COVID. But bats might also help us find a cure. But even if they don't, it's important to note how useful bats are as long as they stay bats and don't turn into Dracula. They are often viewed in China as a symbol of good luck. Welcome to Ladder Cat Productions, the place for health, science, and fun. Bats are mammals of the order Chiroptera. This word is Greek and means handwing. They make up 1/5 of all living mammal species and can be found on 6 continents. There are more than 1,300 different bat types, each with unique abilities. Some weigh less than a penny, while others have a 6-foot wingspan. There are 2 main bat types, microbats and megabats. Most bats are microbats and eat insects like moths that come out at night. Vampire bats are a microbat type, but they are the exception because they feed on blood rather than insects and they don't kill the animals they take the blood from. They particularly like cattle and horse blood. Megabats live in the tropics and eat fruit, nectar, and pollen. They have eyes and a stronger sense of smell than microbats and don't echolocate like microbats do. There are more than 150 species of megabats, which are usually but not always bigger than microbats. The bats have arms that form wings and have bone structure similar to people. They are the only mammals that are capable of sustained flight. Depending on the species, some bats can reach speeds of 100 miles per hour. Bats are more maneuverable than birds. They have very long spread out digits with thin membrane wings. The bones in the wings work like fingers that are very flexible, allowing the bat to have a full range of movement. A bat can urinate or defecate in flight as well. Bats pass stool through their mouth. Bat droppings are called guano. Due to bats eating up to 2/3 of their body weight of insects daily, the guano sparkles. The limbs of the bat usually feature 2 sharp claws. They have a shorter claw that is similar to a human thumb. The longest living bat is 41 years old. A tiny bat from Siberia set this world record in 2006. It is said the smaller the bat, the shorter its lifespan. Most species in the wild average 20-year lifespans. Bats are nocturnal, which allows them greater ability to avoid their predators and less competition for food. Bats use echolocation, which are sound waves bouncing off objects to find food and fly safely. Bats have light bones and webbing that allow them to fly and cover during sleep. Like cats, bats clean themselves. The colonial bat is even known to groom each other. This cleaning controls parasites and helps them to have sleek fur. Bats can be found in polar regions, extreme deserts, and isolated islands in dense forests or wetlands. They like to roost in cracks and crevices, caves, tree hollows, and old buildings. Most bats hibernate during the winter. Many bats live in giant colonies with millions of other bats. All bats roost upside down. They hang from their hind feet and like to cover themselves with their wings. In this way, if they have to escape quickly, they can let go and fall into flight. Bats have few natural predators. Owls, hawks, and snakes eat bats. Bats are very useful. They consume millions of bugs and are a way of controlling pests for plants. Nectar-drinking bats pollinate plants so they can produce fruit. More than 500 plant species depend upon bats for pollination, including mangoes, bananas, and avocados. Fruit-eating bats also disperse seeds, so rainforests can grow. Bats help spread seed for nuts, figs, and cacao, which is the main ingredient in chocolate. You can thank a bat for the candy bar and chocolate icing you enjoy. Bats also help us with plants like agave or the iconic saguaro cactus. A long-nosed bat has a 3-inch long tongue to feed on the nectar in desert environments. Bats mate with multiple partners to ensure fertilization success. Once the female roosts, it has a 50 to 60 day gestation cycle. Female bats that have reproduced are called dams, while the males that have reproduced are called sires. Baby bats are called pups, and a group of bats is called a colony. Like other mammals, mother bats feed their pups breast milk rather than insects. Mother bats hold their pups in their tail pouches. These pups are only an inch long and suckle milk from their mothers. Mother bats often fly with their young, who cling to their mom's underarm nipple with their mouths and hang onto her waist with their toes. Carrying a pup more often than a third your weight is no small feat. Some bat mothers leave their pups hanging to go get food. Bats can hunt and feed themselves about 3 weeks after birth, which is when they start to fly. Most mama bats only give birth to one bat annually. However, there are a few species of bats that can have a litter of four. Mama bats give birth upside down. Bats have navels because of mom's umbilical cord. Types of bats. Vampire bats are found in the Americas. Their food source is blood, a dietary trait called hematophagy. There is a common vampire bat, a hairy legged vampire bat which feeds on bird blood, and a white-winged vampire bat. Vampire bats have very sharp front teeth that allow to puncture their prey with little effort or notice from their prey. The vampire bats have an anti-clotting factor in their saliva, keeping the blood flowing. Vampire bats use receptors from the nose to help them find food. Vampire bats have short muzzles that are cone-shaped. They have a small tail and small ears. They only weigh about 2 ounces, yet they can consume about 1 ounce of blood a night. It takes about 20 minutes for them to consume the blood from a single host. They can't go more than 2 days without food. If a bat can't find food, it returns to its roost, where it can share regurgitated blood from other vampire bats that were more successful. They typically can live 9 years in the wild and 12 years in captivity. Egyptian fruit bats. These bats are small and have a length about 6 inches. They have a 2 feet wingspan. They weigh less than 1/2 pound. The males are larger and they have a prominent scrotal sac. They have a light brown body color and darker brown wings. The ears of these bats are long and pointed. The snout of these bats looks similar to a canine. They have large dark eyes. Their fur is soft. Sometimes these bats are called flying fox. They have a long tongue that stays coiled up around the rib cage when they aren't feeding. These bats live in Africa, India, and Pakistan. The lowlands, mountains, and everything in between seem to be suitable habitats for these bats. They seem to adapt well to living conditions that would be difficult for other bat species to survive. They are believed to be the most vocal bat. During the day, they sleep and will also groom. They often create colonies of 1,000s. They stay very close to each other for safety and warmth. They sleep upside down with their wings folded in across them. They use echolocation to find food. They speak with high-pitched squeals and clicks. These sounds allow echoes and waves to come back to them. The gestation period is about 115 days, and usually a single offspring will arrive. The mothers care for them about their first 6 weeks. At 3 months, their wings are strong enough for self-flight. Offspring almost always stay in the same colony from birth to death. They can live 8 to 10 years in the wild and average 22 years in captivity. Bumblebee bats, also known as hognosed bats, are a near-threatened bat species due to habitat degradation and disturbance of roosting sites. This bat is in Thailand and Myanmar, where it occupies limestone caves along rivers. This bat is the world's smallest mammal. It is 1.1 to 1.3 inches in height and weighs 0.07 ounces, or 2 grams. It has large ears and its eyes are small and mostly concealed by fur. It has large upper incisors. The wings are large and darker in color with long tips that allow the bat to hover. It has no visible tail. There is a large web of skin between the hind legs that may help in flying and catching insects. It has a reddish-brown or gray coat with a distinctive pig-like snout. The colony's average is 100 bats per cave. The bat feeds in the evening for about 30 minutes and in the dawn for 20 minutes on insects in forest areas. Females give birth annually to a single offspring. Panda bats. This bat has been newly discovered in South Sudan. The bat's covering is similar to a panda. It's been said to look like a tiny panda with wings. It is a rare bat species. Since 1939, only 5 specimens of the species had ever been recorded. Giant golden crown flying bat. The giant golden crown flying fox bat is rare. It has very long wings that are often seen with them wrapped around its body like a cloak. The wings can be up to 5 feet wide when fully displayed, and they weigh about 2.5 pounds. It is considered to be the largest bat in the world. This bat has a face that resembles a face of a fox. It has a long snout and have ears that are pointed and not round like most bat species. Even though they have golden brown fur on their head, the rest of the bat, including its wings, is black. They don't have a tail. They live in deep caves and the rainforest. The specific bat locations are Maitum and Mindanao. They typically follow the routes of the riverbed due to being able to readily find food sources. They take a great deal of care in personal grooming. They will use their wings to scoop the water up and put it all over the body. They roost in large colonies. Many travel as much as 25 miles per night looking for food. They consume fruit. As they fly, they spit out seeds from the fruits, and this helps with the pollination process. They consume figs and lamio. It is believed a female has 2 annual breeding seasons, but she will only produce a single offspring during one of them. This bat is heavily being poached and is in competition with humans for fruit. It is in danger of becoming extinct. The forest areas continue to be destroyed by humans, which gives them less of a habitat for food and shelter. The fruit bat is a megabat and in some locations are called the flying fox. There are many differences in their size from one location to the next. Some are 2 inches long and some are 16 inches long. Some only weigh 1 ounce or 2 and others weigh 2 pounds. The wing length can be more than 5 feet. They have large eyes and excellent vision of all bat species. Their vision and sense of smell help them find food as well as help them avoid danger. It has sharp teeth to penetrate the skin of the fruit. They also have long tongues that unroll when they are feeding. When they aren't eating, the tongue stays rolled up. It is tucked away internally around the rib cage rather than remaining in the mouth. The shape of its wings can be different due to its location. The wings may be of different design to help compensate for wind and other elements in their natural environment. When fruit bats rest during the day, they do so by hanging upside down high up in the trees. This gives them more protection from predators and gives them darkness. They may hide in crevices and other dark spaces as well. They typically stay close to bodies of water. The females give birth to 1 offspring at a time. They carry the young for about 6 months. The fruit bat won't mate when struggling for habitat or food. Little brown bat. This bat is small with a body size of 2.5 to 4 inches. They weigh no more than 1/2 ounce. The span of their wings can be up to 11 inches. They are brown in color and have short, round ears. They are typically found living around swamplands. They have also been found in cold areas like Alaska where they hibernate. They also are well known in Georgia and Arkansas. The largest recorded number of them in the United States is in New Hampshire. The only states where they don't live are Texas, Florida, and Mexico. There are more of these kind of bats in the United States and Canada than any other bat species. The bat sleeps and grooms during the day. They are fast creatures and hunt at night. They live in caves and mines during the winter. The hibernation cycle can last from 4 to 6 months. They eat insects. Wasps and moths are the majority of their diet. They can consume up to half their body weight nightly. Most of the time, this bat consumes its meals while in flight. They have sharp molars and canines that are shaped in a manner that allow them to hold on to their prey in flight. They will also use the tip of their wing to capture food. They use echolocation. They often pick insects off the fur of other animals. It can slow its body weight during the day if it doesn't find enough food. The female can mate from 7 to 9 months of age. The males mature later at a year old. Even though mating is in the fall, the female can delay the fertilization of the sperm and egg until springtime. The young are born in late June or early July. Typically, only one offspring is born at a time. When they are 1 month old, they are self-sufficient colony members. Indiana bat. This bat is medium-sized. It can range in color from brown, black, or gray. They are 1 or 2 inches in length when full-grown. They weigh about 1/4 of an ounce. They have very small toes, and they are the only bat species to have pink lips. The Midwestern United States are the most common places they are found in. In the winter months, these bats may travel long distances to find caves to hibernate. They also live in the eastern and western United States. Colonies of these bats may meet up for hibernation. There can be thousands of them in one location. In warmer weather, they break into smaller colonies again. They like to hibernate in the state of Indiana, which is why they are so named. They sleep very close to each other in tight spaces. They consume insects. The lifespan is typically 9 to 12 years. Mature females give birth to one offspring in the middle of the summer. They are self-sufficient by 1 month old. Indiana bats mate during fall before they enter caves to hibernate. The female bats store the sperm through winter and become pregnant in spring soon after they emerge from the caves. Inside a bat colony, a subcolony is formed for pregnant females. They will care for their young in this area. Once the young is self-sufficient, they leave that subcolony. The lifespan of this bat is 9 to 12 years. More than half the population of this bat has dropped since 1975. They are considered endangered. Humans keep killing the bats, and pesticides used on fruit kill them, and their forest is often being removed. In many areas of Indiana, it is illegal to go into caves during the winter because they can disturb the bats' hibernation, causing the bats to need to feed when there isn't enough food available. Unfortunately, this law is hard to enforce. Thank you for watching our video. Please like, watch, and subscribe. See you next time!